हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि जयं विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राज काचार्य श्रीमद हेजट भैनग्रह श्री भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद जी महाराज की जय। इसका विभुटी संस्थापक आचार्य श्रील प्रभुपाद जी महाराज की जय। जगत गुरु श्रील सिद्धांत सरस्वत ठाकुर श्रील प्रभुपाद जी महाराज की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव भक्तवृंद की जय। श्री श्री गौर नित्यानंद प्रभु की जय। कृष्ण बलराम की जय। जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्रा महारानी की जय। श्री श्री राधा माधव जीव की जय। पंचदत्त नृसिंहदेव भगवान की जय। ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवतम की जय। संबित वैष्णव भक्त वृंद की जय। निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल। ओं अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। नमो विष्णुपदाय कृष्ण प्रस्थाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवी गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणी। हे कृष्ण करुणा सिंधु दीन बंधु जगतपते गोपेश गोपिका कांत राधा कांत नमस्तुते। तप्त कंचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिये। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्येव च पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो। नमो महाबदान्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्य नाम्ने गौरत्वसे नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि श्री गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओं नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओं नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। हरे कृष्ण। First of all, I want to pay my respect to all of his senses at the lotus feet of my spiritual master, Sri Srimad Gaur Govinda Swami Srila Gurudev. And also I want to pay my respect to all of his senses at the lotus feet of ISKCON Founder Acharya H.T. Bhanagres, Isi Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupadji Maharaj. Paying my obeisances at the lotus feet of Sadhu, Guru, Vaishnava and Acharyas. And also I want to pay my respectful obeisances to the Vaishnavs assembly here. By the mercy of Sriman Mahaprabhu, Sriman Nityananda Prabhu, and by previous acharyas, we are hearing from Srimad Bhagavatam, especially from Kunti Stuti, How sincerely Kunti Devi is praying with humility also. I have no qualification to see you, to know you. Although personally, she was standing before Krishna. Out of humility, and also actually, this is Tattva, this is Siddhanta. We are not qualified to see Krishna. Why we are not qualified to see Krishna? She just explaining. Krishna is adhukhyaja. By our material senses, senses are not qualified. Again, we say in English, perceptions. We have no power. Some transcendentalness is required. You can say, like, to know Krishna, to realize Krishna, Krishna's blessing is required. Krishna's potency is required. Chit Shakti is required. Because although we are part and parcel, we are part and parcel of Krishna, but we are attached towards Maya. This is the problem. Like day before we are discussing how our senses, mind, intelligence have thousands of coverings, material coverings. So we cannot remove it. We have no qualification to see Krishna. First one, Krishna has bent our material perception, adhukhyajam. And our position? Maya javanika charanam. Maya is creating another problem. Maya wants to cover us, cover our knowledge, identification, our swarup. Maya is creating one problem. And from our side also one problem. Mudhadrusham. We are not very advanced in spiritual life or spiritual identity constitutions. Our constitution is spiritual. But due to we are staying in this material body, we are addicted with material propensity. This is called in Sanskrit adhyas. Adhyas means when continuously our habit became matured. Habit means like our senses, our mind, our intelligence. Always addicted to it. It is called adhyas. Although we are part and parcel of Krishna, because we are always thousand of life before we are always in body, with material body, this material consciousness is always covering our spiritual identities. This is a great hindrance in our spiritual life. Krishna is beyond material perception, Maya is getting problem, and our position is we are agya. So three things are there. Therefore, it is not easy for a conditioned soul to realize Krishna's pastime, Krishna's form, to release Krishna's transcendental leelas, not possible. Kunti Devi is saying, although I am standing in front of you, I don't know who are you. How can you say, you standing in front of someone, in eye you are seeing this Prabhu is standing like that, but you can say, I don't know who are you. Actually, Krishna performing such a leela in Pandava's life, they are realizing in one part, Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead, but in another way, they're sometimes in delusion. Why Krishna is playing like that? Kunti Devi is saying. You are staying outside, you are staying inside. Antara vahir vyavasthitam. Krishna is staying outside. Outside he was sitting on the chariot. And inside the womb of Uttara. You are Supreme Personality of Godhead. She is saying you are a Supreme Personality of Godhead, but saying same time, I don't know why. That means, because according to our standard, with material consciousness, to realize a pure devotee and a pure state, a pure existence of Krishna, Krishna's dham, Krishna's name, not possible. Like we know, holy name is everything. We know. From different shastra we are always hearing holy name is everything. But when we are chanting holy name, we are not realizing that thing. We have no power to realize all these things. Kunti Devi, she was Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur giving one nice commentary on that, on this verse. Why I am saying this thing? Many people, many persons in Mahabharata, in Srimad Bhagavatam, they realize that thing. Actually, who is Krishna? Why he is performing such a leela? Sometimes they know leela, but they don't know leela tattva. Bhishmadev is saying, three persons within this three world only know Krishna's leela. They know leela, not to vidishchitam. Nahi asya kaschit rajan puman veda vidishchitam. This is in first canto, Pitama Bhishmadev. He is saying to Yudhishthir, nahi asya kaschit rajan. No one knows Krishna's desire. No one knows. Although he was a devotee, an alert devotee, but he don't know. Therefore, Rupa mentioning in that purport, it is useless to inquire why Pandavas are suffering. It is useless. And it is also applicable to us. It is useless to inquire why I am suffering. It is useless. Because no one knows what is Krishna's desire. Only he knows. How he wants to play with us, only he knows. We don't know. Already we know we are like a doll, huh? Puppet. So puppet, a doll have power to dance? No, he have no power. He have no power. So we can't say, I have power, we can do. No, we should not inquire anything in our spiritual life about happiness and distress. Whatever is coming. Bhaktivinoda mentioning one of his points. Krishna Icha Mate Sab Ghatai Ghatana Tahe Sukha Dukha Hai Avidya Kalpana. What is ignorance? This is also ignorance. Prabhupada giving one example, always giving one definition. Ignorance means when someone thinks body as soul. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur's definition on ignorance. Krishna Icha Mate Sava Ghatai Ghatana. What is happening in my life, or what was happening in my life, or what will happening in my life, is by Krishna's desire. But if you want to calculate this is happiness, this is distress, this is avidya. So we are in avidya or not? We are in avidya. We are always calculating. We are always like a businessman, always with calculator calculating. How much loss, how much profit? We are always calculating our spiritual lives. Material lives. No calculations, no calculator. Krishna is owner. He will calculate. Our business to serve Guru and Krishna. Tahe sukha dukha hai avidya kalpana. This is ignorance. If someone is always thinking why I am suffering, why this problem is coming, why that is coming, this is ignorance. Whatever is coming in my spiritual life, it is by desire of Guru and Krishna. Then we can lead our spiritual life. Otherwise, very difficult. Three persons, they know Krishna's leela, not to vidhishchitam, what Krishna want to do. We don't know. You just realize your life. You know you will become ISKCON devotee. You know you will save your head. You know you will be such a guru. You don't know. then without knowing such things, if this happening to my life, then why I will do something for future? Like our Gurudev used to say, whatever in your destiny, it will come. No one can give more and no one can take from you. It is a common thing in Urya. Gurudev used to say, these things. What is in your destiny, it will come. But we have two things. In destiny and destiny's master, Krishna, and his pure devotees, Guru. Two supports are there now. We should not calculate. This is ignorance, always calculating. This is loss, this is profit, this is happiness, this is distress. Whatever is coming, when I am surrendered at the lotus feet of Guru and Krishna, whatever is coming according to his desire. What is the real problem? Bhaktivinoda Thakur, next verse is saying, this is the real problem in spiritual life.
Jaha Krishna Ichha Kare Taha Jana Bhalo Tejiya Apana Ichha Ghuchao Janjalo.
All these are key points in spiritual life. One may be very expert, learned, whatever he may be. If he don't know all these secrets, he will defeat. Because mind is there. Mind sometimes, devotees always saying, oh, I am doing some service but not getting the result. I am trying but it's not happening. But what Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying? Jaha Krishna Ichha Kare Taha Jana Bhalo. Whatever is coming in my life, whether happiness or distress, this is Krishna's will. That is good for me. But one thing we have to do. Tejiya apana ichha ghuchao janjal. Give up your own desire. That means, in another word, spiritual life means you have to, commit suicide. Social suicides like that. You cannot act whimsically. You have no separate desire than Guru and Krishna's desire. This is spiritual life. Very subtle life. Tejya apana ichha. Whatever your desire, just give up it. And this is the ghuchao janjal. This is the real problem in spiritual life. You try. Whenever you have no desire, then no problem. When you have little desire, problem start. I have no other desire. Therefore, Shastra said, Vidhi and Nishad. How can you say? Vidhi, you have to do. This is the principle. And Nishad, don't do. Do and don't do. What to do and what not to do? Guru Mukha Padma Vakya, first. All these are, essence or foundation or sum and substance of our spiritual life. Spiritual life starts from that point. Sentimentally, if we overcross or overlaps these things, there is chance of fall down. Shastra always saying this thing, where one is Vidhi, you have to do this thing, and Nishad, don't do this thing. Vidhi, Guru Mukha Padma Vakya. This is Vidhi. This is order, this is law of all Shastras. And Nishad, don't do, ar na kariha manne asa. Don't think, accept Guru's order, don't think anything. That means, keep your desires, subtle material desires. Therefore, in past day we are discussing this, I like this point. In front of a pure devotee, you have to lead your life like a living dead body. You are although living, but your body is like dead. That means you have no independence. Like a robot, how can you say in English, robot, huh? In computer, how robot dancing? I don't know. I only hear. Robots, in plastic dolls. My pronunciation is not good. Puppets, huh? A robot, robot dancing like that. Someone just playing or operating switch, robot is dancing. Our life is like that.
But one problem always we are facing in our spiritual life,
apna ichha.
Our desire, our will,
it could be a problem.
Therefore, it is very difficult to know Guru and Krishna and their absolute platforms,
absolute position.
How Vishwanath Chakur Thakur is giving one example. Pandavanam subhaktanam palaneopi sarvantarjamyopi muhurapi asuttamadi pandavadhartam astragahayasi. Why I am not able to understand you, Kunti Devi is saying. She is just giving many points. You are maintaining Pandavas because Pandavas are your devotees. But I know who is Asuttama. You are in Asuttama's heart as super soul, and through Asuttama you want to kill Pandavas.
Kunti Devi is saying.
Otherwise, who is Asuttama? He's not very powerful than you. What capacity he have? He can challenge your devotees. You are saving your devotees, and Asuttama have power to kill Pandavas. You are doing. This is spiritual life. Whatever is coming, it is coming through Guru and Krishna. Maybe happiness, maybe distress. Same time you are saving Pandavas, and same time to kill Pandavas, through Asuttama, you are sending this Brahmastra. This is my experience, Kunti Devi said.
Swayam nyasta sastropi astram grunhasi. In Sanskrit, Vishwanath Chakur,
you already told in Mahabharata, I will not, how can you say, I will not use my dis or any weapons. But sometimes, to save Pandavas, I saw personally, to save Pandavas, you using your dish. Then who are you? I don't know actually why you are doing like that. You say, I don't want to use my dish or weapon, but now you are using. Saving Pandavas and throw Asuttama you want to kill.
Dopadi Subhadrayo Sista Palana Prabhuti of Api Bhismadinam Sanghara.
You are always take care of devotees, huh? But you told to Arjun, kill Pitama Bhishma. You told my son.
Then how can I understand you? Kunti Devi giving such nice nice logic. How can you say logic? Or
I can't say nice points. You are always maintaining your devotee, always protecting your devotee, but same time you are saying to one devotee to kill another devotee. You are saying to Arjun to kill Pitama Bhishma. Then how can I know you? That means three persons know Krishna's Leela, but they don't know Krishna's Vidhishchitam. What Krishna want to do in our life? We don't know. Even what he want to do in this three world, we don't know. He is supreme. If we know Krishna, then you are greater than Krishna. If you know Guru, that means your knowledge is higher than Guru. Then how you become a disciple? If you know Guru, that means your knowledge is now higher than Guru. If you know Krishna, then your knowledge is higher than Krishna. Three persons. They were in Kapila, Lord Kapildev, Devarsi, Narad. And Devarsi Narada, Narada Kapila Muni. Another I just forgot. Three persons they know. Kapil, Lord Kapil. No. Three persons. First canto. Pitama Bhishma Dev saying. Kapil Dev and also Nara. Shiva. Shivji, Kapila and Narad. They know Krishna's Leela, but they don't know what Krishna want to do. Like here, Kunti Devi say, you are protecting anybody, but through Arjun you want to kill Pitama. And another, She is giving another point. Drupadi Subhadrayo Atisnihan Apihitat Putran Ghatayasi. You like so much to Drupadi and Subhadra, your sister. So much affection. But same time, you are killing their son. Not saying Asatthama killing, you are killing. Ghatayati means throw Asatthama you are killing, not saying that you are killing. Throw Asatthama you are killing. Why he is saying like that? Because Kunti Devi knows Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. By his will everything is happening. No one is more powerful than Krishna. How Asatthama is more powerful? He has power to kill Drupadi's son. You are doing all these things. Although I saw you personally and I am standing in front of you, but I have no power to see you. Pitama Bhishma also saying same thing to Yudhishthira Maharaj. Nahi asya kasti rajan puman veda vidischitam jad vidijgyaya saya yukta muihanta muihanti kabayo pihi. If you, like devotees asking many questions, why? You can ask why, but you can't ask why. Why Krishna done that thing? Does that thing? You can't say. Who saying? Pitam Bhishma saying. Yad vijigyaya saya yukta. If someone wants to inquire you, why Krishna performing all these leelas? And he's saying, muhyante kavayo pihi. If he is very talented person, then he will be also in muhyante, means delusion. Eh? Delusion, illusion. Builded. Yes, same. Builded. Learned persons builded also. If they want to know why Krishna want to perform all these lives. So it is better not to inquire why. Why Krishna is performing all these lilas? Why this is happening in my life? Who knows? Guru knows. Krishna knows. I have to serve. I don't know what will happen. Therefore Kunti Devi is saying, I don't know. Because you are beyond of material perfection. I am a conditioned soul and same time my eyes covering my vision. So only I am repeatedly paying obeisance to you. Bhakti anavigya kevalam pranamam karomi. I am not very expert in devotional service. Only I am paying obeisance at your lotus feet. This is, how can you say, safest way. Safest way. And easiest way. If we inquire many things, what we can get? Like Gurudev used to say, if you like churning, okay, churning. Manthan, like churning. We are churning yogurt. If you read all shastras, study all shastras, only two things. You may inquire thousands of questions, only two things you can get. Essence is two things. Nam seva and guru seva. Gurudev used to say. To serve spiritual master and chant Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. This is the symptom. How can you know you are free from Maya? How can you realize other that this devotee is free from Maya? Like we are hearing before, Sadhu Shastra Kripai Jadi Krishna unmukha hai, sei jivan istara maya tahare chhadai. If someone wants to serve, his spiritual hankering is coming to chant holy name, to serve Krishna, that means he is now free from maya. But how can you know the symptoms? How can you know? Mahaprabhu giving same answer. Mahaprabhu giving another answer in same chapter. Tate Krishna bhaje kare guru ra sevan माया जाल छुटे पाए कृष्णेर चरण. All are secret points, key points of Shastra. You may study many Shastras, you may preach whole life, but you forget these two things, then your life will be miserable. And this is the nature of a devotee who is free from Maya. Tate Krishna bhaje kare guru rasevan. Simultaneously, just like you can see in a rail train, the train wheels moving on two tracks, iron tracks, simultaneously moving. If someone is free from Maya, this is the symptom. Simultaneously, Krishna bhajan and guru sevan. To serve spiritual master, tate Krishna bhaje kare guru ras sevan. Maya jala chute paaye. Maya is just like net. Now you are free from Maya. Paaye Krishna racharan. Then you are eligible to get Krishna's lotus feet. You can identify someone, you can know someone that he is free from Maya. How much he inclined towards guru service and Krishna bhajan. More he inclined, Maya will release him. Maya have no power. Because he want to serve a pure devotees. And by serving a pure devotees, Krishna become pleased. When Krishna become pleased, Maya have no power to interrupt you or to capture you. Where is Maya's power? Maya is very minute. Maya showing power in front of us. But Maya have no power in front of a pure devotees, in front of Krishna. Maya always staying back side. But for pure devotees, for Krishna, Maya is always in back. For us, Maya is always in front. Maya is powerful. We are saying Maya is very powerful, very strong. In front of us, not in front of a pure devotees. Therefore, tate Krishna bhaje kare guru rasyapan. All essence you can find in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Therefore, Prabhupada Gurudev used to say this is like pija, postgraduate course. All Shastra Siddhanta in Bhagavatam and Bhagavat's conclusion in two literature. Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Narton Thakur's poet and in Sisi, Chaitanya Charitamrita. Conclusions. If you are not expert to conclude, to draw the conclusion, you'll be deluded. Now this is a problem. Now this is a great challenge and also a problem in our devotional life. We are not, how can we bring the essence, siddhantas. We have no power to draw the siddhantas. Actually, what we have to do? What Shastra is saying? Shastra's three adhikaris are there. Adhikaris, how can I say? Three qualified persons, position, eligible. Karma adhikaris are there. Jnana adhikaris are there and bhakti adhikaris are there. In Kali Yuga, mostly Gurudev used to say 99% karma adhikaris. 99%. They have no bhakti adhikar. They don't like. You see, even you stay anywhere, even they will stay in Dham or they will stay anywhere, they will do same business. Karma adhikar. Always want to earn money, enjoy this thing. Okay, for that thing, you just offer everything to Guru and Krishna. For karma adhikar is varnasram dharma. For karma adhikar is, those are very attached to fruity works. Okay, you just perform your work and offer its result to Guru and Krishna. And through varnasram systems. This first step. Therefore, Prabhupada knows all these things. You want to establish Daiva Varnasram. Devotees have, conditioned souls. In Kali Yuga devotees, they have no power to chant Hare Krishna 24 hours, no spontaneous love for Krishna. In bathroom, we are bathing, cleaning our body for how many hours? 45 minutes, half an hour. But we have no power to see Krishna half an hour. We can stay in bathroom for 1 hour, but we have no power to stay in temple 1 hour. You just saw. But devotees, temple is looks like a prison house. Just after Guru Puja, go. After Snarth, just go. After Bhaktam class, just go. In bathroom, we can spend hour and hour, but in temple, we have no power to spend 1 hour. We are karma adhikaris. We are always attached to fruitive activities. Our like bodily conception of life, always. Therefore, for us, varnasrama dharma. Okay, whatever you want to do, do for the pleasure of Guru and Krishna. Then, by performing karma adhikar, then your heart became clear. Heart became, how can I say, that is, you will remove. Karma adhikaris. When many devotees asking, I am performing bhajan for 25 years, I am in ISKCON, I am doing this thing, that. But if you are in ISKCON, you are chanting 16 round, if you are doing something for pleasure of Guru and Krishna, not for your pleasure, you will come to second stage. Your heart will be cleansed. Then you can know who is Guru, who is Krishna, what is the power of holy name. Additional Bhagavatam. Then you can know. Many devotees have this same question. I am serving, but why the result is not come? You are serving, but what is your desire? This is most serious point. In Bhakti Yoga, Bhava Siddhi, what you are doing, it is not important. Why you are doing it? Why are you performing all the activities? What is your mood? This is important. Just like you see, like sweepers are in their temple. Why they are working? For seva? For money. For money they are working. Their mood is money. But someone can say, oh, he's working. Why is working? Someone performing seva in temple, why is performing? This is important. We cannot add everything towards bhakti, pure bhakti, no. If you have other desire and sometimes you are performing some seva, then you can at best get some pious result. Forget about bhakti. Pious result. In this life, at least you can get some bhakti sukrutis. Not pure bhakti, because you have desire. You have desire. Mostly eligible for karma adhikaris. If they surrender at lotus feet of Guru and Krishna and under direction of a bona fide spiritual master, if they perform some activities, then they go to Gyanadhikar stage. Gyanadhikar stage means chitta suddhi. Heart became cleansed. Then you can know the swarup tattvas. What is Maya? What is Krishna? What is Guru? Everything you can know at that time. But in Gyanadhikar stage, third one is there. Third one? Bhakti Adhikar. Eligible to perform only pure bhakti. We can at best go to Gyanadhikar, but not to Bhakti Adhikar. we have no power. Because Bhakti Adhikar means require eternal, how can I say? Antaranga Sakti. Internal potency. Internal potency. We are in external energy. We want some chit sakti. And Guru, a pure devotee, if he have such power, if he is our mercy unto you, then this eternal potency descend on you. We call this as mercy. What is mercy? This is mercy. The chit sakti, the eternal potency working within the heart of a pure devotee, when you please a pure devotee, then this chit sakti will descend on your senses, on your heart. Then now you are spiritualized. Now you are eligible to perform bhakti. Now bhakti adhikar came. And where is conclusion? In Sisi is conclusion. Mahatera kripa vina kaun karme bhakti nai. Krishna bhakti dure thaku sansara nai khyai. Mahaprabhu told to Sanatana Goswami, about vidhi bhakti, about raganuga bhakti, and concludes last is saying, mahatera kripa bina kon karme bhakti na. You may try whole life to get pure bhakti, but without mercy from a pure devotees, without mercy from Gauranga Mahapurus devotees, pure devotees, kon karma by other activities you cannot achieve pure bhaktis. What to speak about pure bhaktis? Krishna bhakti dure thaku, sansar nahi kya. We will face same problems, same material problems. Therefore, most of the time devotees are harassed. I am devotee, my wife is devotee, why this problem is coming? Problem is in demigods. Problems are in demigods. Sometimes they have chance to associate with Krishna in their leelas. When Krishna came to Dwaraka, Mathura, they are in such a higher position, still problem is there. Only our problem will be removed. We can kick up all the problems. When this mercy potency, this eternal potency descend by Guru's mercy to us, then now we are spiritualized. When we are spiritualized, no problem. That is bhakti adhikar. And without bhakti adhikar, mercy from a pure devotee, we have no power to kick out material miseries. Karmi people, they don't know. At least bhakta, a devotee should convince on that point. If you not achieve pure devotional service, pure bhakti, then problem will come. Mahaprabhu is saying. And Prahlad Maharaj is saying, Naisam matistavaturu kramangi. You saw Prahlad Maharaj. Naisam matistavat. You may try your best to fix your mind at lotus feet of Krishna. It will not possible for the conditions. All these siddhantas are ornament of our paramparas. We are not sentimentalists. We are always saying about Guru, Guru, Mahat. We are not sentimentalists. Our siddhanta is always based on Bhagavatam. Always set on Bhagavatam. Now devotees have no faith towards Guru, towards Parampara, towards Acharyas, towards Mantras, towards Bhagavatam, towards Deity. Therefore all problems is coming. Spiritual problems start when you have no faith towards your spiritual master and Acharyas, Paramparas. Then all problems, you will face all problems. Therefore Prabhupada always adding one word, bona fide spiritual master, bona fide discipline success. We must have to put unflinching faith. This is not sentiment. Naisam matistavatu rukramangi. One may be very talent, even he may not have material desires. Many yogis are in, now it is very difficult to find out, but before many yogis are there in Himalaya, they have full control over their senses, self-control. Prabhupada told three things. Unless you are self-controlled, discipline, and another one. Unless you became obedient, discipline, and self-control, it is not possible to serve your spiritual master. You don't, now devotees, they are not scrutinizedly reading Prabhupada books. But as I remark, whenever you read any purport, anything, all commentaries, but compare with Prabhupada giving a suitable language and perfect language and essence of all commentaries. Unless one is disciplined, obedient, and self-control, without so, it is not possible to serve spiritual master. And without doing that, or without so, it is not possible to return back to Godhead, Prabhupada says. Discipline, obedient, and self-control. We are discussing that point. Even yogis, they are very disciplined, they are very self-controlled, and third one, obedient. but they are not eligible to go to Goloka Vrindavan. Why? If someone wants, someone have a desire, strong desire to get pure bhakti, then you have to get mercy from a pure devotees who have eternal potency. Ladini, chitsakti ladini, sarvatva. Bhakti Vinod Thakur always mentioning. The essence of chitsakti is ladini, and this ladini potency descend through guru parampara with your devotees. And if you got his mercy, then you are now eligible to perform your bhakti. There Prahlad Maharaj giving this challenge to his father. Although I am son, Vishwanatha Chakravarti mentioning in that commentary, Hiranyakashipu asking, you are my son. If you are your mind is fixed at lotus feet of Krishna, why not me? I am father, you are very popped up. He said, no father, you may be father, I may be your son. It is not possible for anyone to fix his mind at lotus feet of Krishna. Naisammati stavat urukramangi spurshyati anarthapam jadartham. He may be senior, may be junior, may be sannyasi, may be grihastha, may be brahmachari, whoever he may be, he have anarthas. And we have no power to kick out anarthas. We have no power. We have power? You try to kick out one anarthas, thousand of life you will try, we cannot kick out. You try. But by Guru's mercy it is possible. Our Siddhant is like that. Prem bhakti jaha haite avidya vinasa jate vedegaya jaharachar. Natanda Thakur is saying, this is not my statement, Veda is saying. Avidya here refers to anarthas. Avidya vinasa jate, that means whatever anarthas you have, only by whose mercy you can kick out and you can get prem bhakti. We have no power, actually, to kick out all anarthas. And without serving a pure devotees, a pure devotee, anala devotees of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, not possible. What to speak of serving now? We have no faith towards parampara. We have no faith towards parampara. This is a problem. If you have no faith towards Prabhupada, how can you lead your life? Now you can see many, many devotees, they jump to another parampara. Oh, Vrindavan, oh, this Maharaj is great, this Maharaj is great, this Maharaj is great. Maharaj is great, but you are not great. You want to, if you want to become, you become a pure disciple, then pure guru will come to you. First try to purify yourself. If someone don't know parampara siddhantas, like our Gurudev say, his life is just like a monkey. Like monkey jumping from one branch to another, one branch to another. If someone knows parampara siddhantas, he, like in one night he want to become a millionaire. It is possible? Now devotee's mentality is like that. I will not doing any perform sadhana. Guru, only by blessing from Guru, I will go to Goloka Vrindavan. They are searching big gurus. Huh? Guru have some specific duty and disciple have also some specific duty. It is good. You have to pray to Nityananda. This is not a way of searching. To find a spiritual master, you cannot search. If you have power to search a pure devotee, then that means you are pure devotees. Like we are discussing, if you know he is pure, that means your knowledge is higher than his. Otherwise, how can you know? No. Only we have to pray to Nityananda Prabhu, Mahaprabhu. Prabhu, you know who is your own man, Gurudev said. Please, you arrange. I want to serve you and your pure devotees. If you pray sincerely by his arrangement will come. Then you can develop unflinching faith. then spiritual life start. Arrangement, material arrangement is like outside faith, inside finish. Like some structure is there, some buildings there, outside nice decorated, but inside pillars very weak. Anytime fall down. Same. Outside we are putting tilak, chanting Hare Krishna. Outside everything is going on, but inside we have no faith to our spiritual master. We don't know his position. Any time we may give up this process. This is basement. You can say in basement, like in structure, we have basements, pillars, beams. How many support you see? So it is not possible, Kunti Devi is saying. I have no power to see you. We are discussing about that thing, karma adhikar, jnana adhikar, and third one, bhakti adhikar. Actually, who is serving Guru and Krishna without any desire, and whatever possessions he have, he was giving everything to Guru and Krishna and don't want anything, then his heart clear, his heart become cleansed, then he can know the position of Guru, holy name, Bhagavatam, deities, then he prays sincerely. When he prays sincerely, without name, fame, prestige and adoration, and spiritual hankering to serve Guru and Krishna more and more, that time mercy will come. That time, pure devotee's mercy will come. Now your full body, senses, everything is now spiritualized. Then you get bhakti adhikar. 24 hour, you can think Krishna. You can chant Krishna's name. And you can think about Guru Krishna's pleasure. This is bhakti adhikar. So, Kunti Devi always repeating this thing. I have no qualification to see you. Only I am paying obeisance to you. Why? Next verse is saying, 20.
Tatha paramahansanam muninam amilatmanam bhakti yoga vidhanartham katham pasya mahistriya.
So nice. Prabhupada always repeating. From this verse, Prabhupada always repeating. Although Kunti Devi, she was very qualified. But this is nature of a devotee. Humility. Humility. Humility is just like ornament of a devotee. One quality will bring all your devotional qualities. It will bring, it will invite. You can earn only by humility. And this is not artificial humility. When more Guru and Krishna please with you, a natural humility will come. Natural. We can see outside people, they are so humble. Rikshawala, very humble. Why they are humble? For money. We don't want this humbleness. Be careful. We are not humble to get something. This is not to achieve something. This is not real humbleness. Humbleness will come. Mercy, when mercy will come, mercy make you humble. You feel yourself fallen. This is nature of mercy. If someone have mercy and he's popped up, it's not possible. No. Not possible at all. Mercy make you humble, simple, gentle, whatever you can say. All good qualities. And mercy is first, how can you say, symptom is humility. Whether your guru, whether Vaishnav, Hari, Guru, Vaishnav, please with you, only you can judge yourself by one point. Not in front of everyone, even yourself when you are chanting, yourself when you are studying, sastras, how you feel humble? How you praying to Krishna? Krishna, how fallen I am? Not in front of Guru or not in front of Krishna's devotees, we are saying I am fallen. Yourself, how much you are feeling? That much mercy you already got. This is symptom. Merciless or mercy will make you humble. And mercy will give you realization. You see, you are in that position. You pray more to get more mercy. If someone not achieve mercy, what is his symptom? Day by day, he think I am perfect, everyone is perfect. Bhakti Shastra is very clear. Why Acharyas are mentioning all these points? To rectify us. We have to study Shastras, we have to hear and we have to pray. Self-help is best help. You have to help yourself. We are not small guy. Always Guru will say, you do this thing, you do this thing. To maintain our family, who is just giving us inspiration? Someone giving you inspiration to maintain your family? Inspiration is coming from your heart. Because you have affection, you have love. So why inspiration is not coming for Guru and Krishna? We have no love, no affection, no mercy there. Guru's mercy will come. Your spiritual hankering will come. And you will feel yourself humble. You think yourself. Although you have all qualities, everyone will praise you, but you will be defeated by yourself. You always defeated by yourself. I am not such a elevated devotee. I have this fault, I have this fault. That means your fault coming to your vision. Mercy will reflect you. And that is the chance. That is the real chance for a devotee. At that point, you have to pray more. Because now mercy flow is coming. Now you have to pray more. Pray to Guru, pray to Vaishnava, pray to Hari. So give me mercy. I want to make this life successful. More we get mercy, more this humbleness, humility will come. And humility will invite all our Vaishnava qualities. And if you lose these qualities, all bad quality will come. You have all other qualities except humility. Then, like a wife or a girl or a woman, you can say anything. She's well looked. She's expert in every aspects. But if she's naked, anyone wants to look her? She is naked. A devotee is like naked. A devotee, he is naked if you have no humility. He may be doing all sort of activities, but no humility. No humbleness. That means he is naked. Therefore, Bhakti Thakur is saying, Haile o sarva gune guni mahasaya pratishtha sa chadi karo omani hridaya. This verse starting from Sri Krishna Kirtane jadi manasa tohar. If you have desire to chant Hare Krishna, if you have keen desire, intense desire, please, with very careful, you just earn this qualities. You may be expert in all set of sevas or qualities, but always pratishtha sa chadi karo amani hrudaya. Give up name, fame, prestige and adoration. And think yourself, I am the lowest, like Gurudev always used to say, I am the lowest of the low. Among the low, I am the lowest. And artificial, we can do it. But this is our achievement, goal. Everyone working for his achievement. What is our achievement? Our achievement is that. To go to that stage. How can we go? By Guru's mercy. You go to any direction, I can show you. Without Guru's mercy, you cannot do anything. Where is Siddhantas? Where is our Siddhantas? In Bhaktivinoda Thakur's prayer,
गुरुदेव कृपा बिंदु दिया करो ये दासे तृणा पे ख्याति ही न
सिद्धांत यू गो एनीवेयर विदाउट मर्सी फ्रॉम ए प्योर डिवोटी देयर इज नो अदर यू कैंट एडवांस वन इंच दिस कंक्लूजन देयरफॉर आवर लाइफ we should mold our life in such a way just like prepare just like in a fire sacrifice an animal is ready you saw in fire sacrifice priest is ready animal is ready sword is ready now only give sacrifice we are like that be ready this body is just like an animal and guru's seva krishna seva parampara seva is just like sacrifice be ready and guru is there with sword he will not kill us he will use us he use this body which always wants bodily pleasure like animal we have to use this body we have to prepare ourselves some from disciple side some task is there to become a real disciple is not easy Give up your own whims, own independence, everything. Be ready, just like you saw, like an animal. Someone just bind with rope, and he just looking. He just looking. We are like that. So we have no power to realize Krishna, to realize pure devotees. Maya is there and is beyond our sense perception. And third one is there. We are ignorant. We have no proper consciousness. Proper consciousness. What is my duty? We are giving so much emphasis on material objects. Actually, this is not our duty. We are not coming for this purpose. We are coming to this material world only for one purpose: how to achieve pure bhakti. Bas. We have to try. If someone is not trying, then you can say he is lazy. Who is not trying? Lazy. Don't be lazy. We have to try. And we have to pray. We have to try. Although we are trying, but it is not easy also. Not easy to realize Guru and Krishna's position to his seva. Dedication is not easy. We have to cry simultaneously, just like train lines, tracks. A try and cry. This is like two tracks. We have to lead our life like that. All acharyas, you see, all acharyas, their life like that. Prabhupada went west there. He have books, everything, but still crying. Krishna, when you help me? Actually. When Guru and Krishna wants to make your life success, he will arrange everything for you, and you have to cry. There is no other way. You have no other way than cry. You may try, but you will fail. Then you have to cry. It's his blessings. All acharyas, their life is like that. So we have no power to realize Guru and Krishna. Therefore, bhakti jnana hina kevalam pranomi. Kunti Devi is saying, I have no bhakti, I have no jnana. Bhakti Vinod Thakur Swami's song is there also. Karma nahi jnana nahi, Krishna bhakti nahi. All essence are there. Nowadays, devotees are not reminding all this, how can you say, prayers. All tradition came from Vrindavan. All these Bhagavata Katha speakers, they are singing all these songs. Now it is coming to our tradition. All these songs. No, we have to sing all these songs. Jai Radhe, Jai Krishna, Bhakti Vinod Thakur songs. Not new songs. What songs they are singing? Govinda bol, Gopal bol. Kya ye It is not a clock, it is not pop dance. No. We have to follow tradition. Because Siddhantas are there. When we sang Sangha Vaishnavas, Krishna becomes pleased. That means we are following authorities. And our Siddhantas are there. Now devotees, if you sing all these songs, that even they don't understand. Why then, why Prabhupada for Western devotees, why Prabhupada just write down books in Bengali? Why in Bengali? Why Prabhupada never consider all our Western devotees, English devotees, they can't understand Bengali. But why Prabhupada write down all these songs in English, all the Bengali songs? Siddhantas are there. Bhaktivinoda Thakur saying, karma nahi, I am so fallen, even I have no capacity, I am not eligible, I am not qualified to perform a pious activities. I am such a fallen. Where is pride? Where is pride? Pride means no devotion. Where is pride? There is no devotion. This is demonic qualities. Where is pride? We don't have pride, but we have, pride means false ego, but we have another thing. We have abhiman. Pride is ahankar. In Sanskrit, what is there? Ahankar and abhiman. Ahankar means false ego. Abhiman means real ego. Without ego, we can't lead our spiritual life. Ego must be there. What should real ego? Siddhanta is there. Chaitanya Charitamrita, Krishna Dasa Abhimane Je Ananda Sindhu Koti Brahma Sukhanai Tare Kabindu. Scrutinizedly you have to study Shastras. Then you can know where are your Siddhantas. What is real ego? Krishna Dasa Abhimane Je Ananda Sindhu. Why a devotee is not feeling happiness? Always you see devotee feeling morose. Oh, what will happen? Why? You have no real ego. I am Krishna's. I am not ordinary human being. I am not a metal person. I am not a grihastha. I am Krishna's das. Krishna das abhiman je ananda sindhu. Ocean of pleasure. Pleasure. Pleasure is there. Pleasure is just like a ocean. If you only develop this abhiman, this real ego, I am Krishna's. And koti brahma sukha nay tar eka bindu. Those brahmavadis, they want some blissness. But only by real ego a devotee gets such a pleasure, even it is not compared to one drop of brahmavadis blissfulness. We have to develop one real ego. I am not belongs to this material world. I am belongs to Krishna, I am belongs to Guru. I am belongs to Guru and Krishna, I am not belongs to this material world. Unless we match our real ego matured, we cannot be in a real position. You cannot work. You cannot continue devotional life. It is like officially devotional service. In English, we can say. Officially devotional service. Not spontaneous devotional service. Because we have no real ego. Some other purpose is there. But if you have real ego, then you can work. That we want. So, karma nahi, jnana nahi, I have no karma. I am not a pious person even. I am such a simple person, I have no capacity to perform some pious activities. And jnana nahi. I am not a knowledgeous person to discriminate what is real knowledge, what is not ignorance. And Krishna bhakti nahi. Even I am no tinge of Krishna bhakti. But only I have one hope. Still bhakti nila could say. If you have no karma, no jnana, no bhakti, then how can you get Krishna's lotus feet? Ohe tuki sei kripa vedar. Only I have one hope that your mercy never depend on, does not depend on karma, jnana and bhakti. Any qualifications. Your mercy, Guru and Krishna's mercy does not depend on any qualification. But one qualification is required. What is that? I am a most insignificant, disqualified person of my spiritual master. Therefore, Gurudev said, disqualification is your real qualification. One devotee asked to Gurudev, Gurudev, you are saying this qualification is required. He said, we are disqualified. Gurudev saying, really you are thinking you are disqualified? When there is a microphone, then we are disqualified. If someone, you give to microphone, he said, I am fallen. When we are preaching, that time we are fallen. After preaching, we are guru. It is not easy to become a natural Vaishnava. Gurudev used to say, be a natural Vaishnava. How we become a natural Vaishnava? Maya already captured us. Our mind, our senses, everything. We have no purification. We father, mother, they are not elevated devotees. Only one. If we get mercy, if in this life, according to our best capacity, if we serve a spiritual master, which is an annihilated devotee of Krishna, pure devotees, then by his blessing, then we can get this achievement. Otherwise, there is no hope. We are disqualified. Even we have no qualification. What to speak? Material, we are disqualified. Therefore, we are here. Who will like us? Now, no one like you. You see, what is, situation is going on in material field. And materially, you are expert means, what is that? If someone is very material expert, that means he is a big ass, big donkey. Today I was reading Prabhupada's books. Prabhupada said, big ass. Who like ass? No one like. Everyone will use you and throwing you, like ass. Owner using ass and send go and take grass in the field, not feeding. And material world is like that. If you become very expert, then all your relatives make you ass. And lastly, give you heavy kick, like football. Where you will go? You can't find your destiny. This is material world. We are disqualified in material world. And if you want to become qualified, then your life is miserable. Therefore, we come to spiritual world. But spiritual world, we have to know one thing. We are coming here to become disqualified. I am a most fallen, disqualified person in this world. When this mood became matured by mercy of Guru and Krishna, then we are eligible to go to Golok Vrindavan. This humility. Katham pasyam mahistriyam. How can I realize you? How can I show you? This is humility. This is only by mercy we can become natural Vaishnavas. Like mercy, Guru's, Krishna's mercy, by his mercy potency, you can rectify yourself. We have no power. We know what is good. You don't know what is good. Chanting 64 round is not good. Serving Krishna is not good. Is not good. Serving spiritual master is not good, but we are not doing. What is good, we know, but we have no power to do this thing. And what is bad, that we know, but we have no power to kick out it. We are so powerful. We are so powerful. What is good, we know. What is bad, we know. But we have no power. What is good to do it, and what is bad to kick out it. But still we are saying, I'm a great devotee. This is our greatness. But only by Guru's mercy, by Krishna's mercy, anartham. Mahiya sampadu raja abhishekam iskinchananam nibrunita javat. Prahlad Maharaj's essence. Unless in your life, you accept a pure devotee as life and soul. And all of your effort, all of your, focus of your life is based on Guru, His pleasure. Then possible to kick out all of this. Otherwise, very difficult, very difficult. You may be sannyasi, you may be whoever you may be. On earth is on earth. Sometimes in grass form, sometimes in subtle form. It will come in different way. Only eternal potency of power to kick out this material energy activities. Therefore, sincere prayer, praying, sincere seva, tate Krishna bhaje kare guru ra seva, two parallel things. Spiritual master service, and how can you serve spiritual master unless you understand his mood? And to understand his mood, still you have to pray. In India, we have this tradition. Wife preparing 3-4 dishes, sabjis. But when she's serving husband, not like that, serving and going somewhere. No. Serving and looking. Which sabji my husband liking? Because her attention to know husband's mood. If she remark, oh, this is my husband liking, next day, or one after two days after, again she preparing. Unless you know someone's mood, you cannot serve. And to know someone's mood, to know pure devotee's mood, we have to pray to Krishna. Krishna, you help me. How can I know your pure devotee's mood? When you know mood, then you can serve. Love will come to serve you. You have to pray continuously. Otherwise, how can we achieve all these qualities? Like Kunti Devi is saying, humility qualities. He's saying, I have no power to see you. Why I have no power to see you? In next verse, Tatha paramahansanam muninam amilatmanam bhakti yoga vidhanartham katham pasya mahistriya. Katham pasya mahistriya. Again saying, I am a O man. Kunti Devi is O man. Man have power to see Krishna? Or a man have power to see Krishna? Who can see Krishna face to face? You are not at that time bodily in conception of life. What is qualification? When you are spiritualized, when you are in super soul, soul platform, then you have a stage to meet super soul. So at that time, you are not here. We are in varnashram system. Someone is woman, someone is man, someone is brahmachari, someone is grihastha. But when you go to Golok Vrindavan, then sannyasi can show his danda. Even guru can say, you give me special besasan. Or disciple, they are guru, disciple, sannyasi, mataji, prabhuji, everyone servant. Spiritual identification. There is no bodily identity. But out of humility, she is saying, Katham pasya mahistriya. How can I see? I am a woman. That was her ornament. Humility. More mercy will come, more make you humble. And lastly, you think, I am the most fallen person in this three world. That is real spiritual position of a devotee. Very high. Our philosophy is very high philosophy. Even sometimes to realize this philosophy, unless you got mercy, even you can't realize it. Can't realize it. You are coming for paramhansas. King Chaha, Siddhar Swami mentioning, King Chaha, paramhansas, atma anatma vivekinam. Krishna coming for these three persons, to teach them what is bhakti. Not for us. Kunti Devi is saying. Even Kunti is saying, you are not coming for me. You are coming for topmost these three class persons. First one, Paramahansas. Like in our Sampradayas, we are always adding Paramahansa Paribrajaka Acharyas. Their Acharyas, their two adjective. Paribrajaka, they are moving always, means to deliver the fallen souls. And what is their real position? They are Paramahansas. Although they are in material world, like swan, immediately can discriminate water and milk. So Guru's position, a pure devotee's position is like that. And you are coming for Paramahansas to teach them what is bhakti. Katham pasyam istri, I am a woman. Paramahansas. And second one, Muninam, Mananasilanam. Those are 24 hours thinking about Krishna, Mananasilanam. For them Krishna is coming. We have no time to think about Krishna. Only 16 Ravana. 2 hours, and within 2 hours, mind is going 2000 times here and there. We are not Munin Manan Silan. But mind only thinking about our own happiness, own distress, this project, that principle. Such a nasty mind, creating all problems. Therefore, Jadabharat Singh Lachar Rahugan, if you want to control this mind, the best way is there, best and suitable way is there. Only one way. Sadhu Guru Chanupasana Astram. Jahi Byalikam is your enemy. Byalikam, Jahi. Immediately you should kill your mind. Like we are discussing, you kill your mind. Now here, this word is in Bhagavad 5th canto. You kill your mind. How can you kill your mind? Sadhu Guru Charana Upasana Astram. This is the weapon. To kill someone, a weapon is required. If I want to kill you, how can I kill you? So, weapon is required. To kill this mind, weapon is required. What is that weapon? Sadhu Guru Charana Upasana. And Prabhupada mentioning in this purport, following the instruction of spiritual master and serving spiritual master is the secret success of spiritual life. 1000 times Prabhupada mentioning the secret of success. But we have no power to see the secret of success. We are searching in net, where is the secret of success? In WhatsApp, in Facebook, we are searching, where is the secret of success, means my spiritual life. Here is the secret of success. Secret of success. To following spiritual master's order as life and soul. Life and soul is the secret of success in our spiritual life. Just one thing, simple. Bhakti yoga is not difficult. Our mind is difficult. Bhakti yoga is very simple. Like you see, road is straight. But child mind is very fickle. Therefore it's playing, going in this direction, in this direction. It's fickle. Mind is fickle. Road is straight. Bhakti yoga is very straight. Very sublime, suitable, straight road. No zigzag way. But mind is creating problem. Jahi Byalikam, you kill. By which weapon? One weapon required. Sadhu Guru Charana Upasana Astram. Or Siddhantas are there. Krishna is coming to teach the Mananasilanam. unless we forget Guru Bhakti, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say. If someone have no power continuously, 24 hours to think about Guru's happiness, he have no power to think Krishna's happiness 24 hours. How can you think about Krishna's happiness? You don't know what is Krishna's happiness. And another statement he was mentioning, whenever you saw the all paraphernalia which belongs to Guru, that is Guru Darshan. After that thing, then Krishna Darshan. Everything is Prabhupada's. Now devotee is saying, ISKCON, huh? ISKCON. ISKCON. If light is, switch is on, okay, security guard will. He will switch up. In your house, you can say like that. Yeah, my wife will switch up. But immediately you are coming, hey, why light is on? Switch up, it is daytime. This is my house. This is ISKCON. This discrimination already came to devotee's mind. Everything is Krishna's, Guru's property. All ISKCON centers, Prabhupada's. Prabhupada's property. All Lakshmi is coming, Prabhupada's property. Guru's, we are not earning, we are sannyasis, someone giving, this is Guru's property. If you misuse one pais, means you are sucking Prabhupada, Acharya's blood. Every ISKCON devotee should trend up like that. Not drinking, okay, I will drink coconut, 25 rupees, 30 rupees. You are earning 35 rupees, you are drinking coconut. Coconut water, huh? Before using 1 rupee, you have to think how much money I am earning for Guru and Krishna. Now devotees are not serious using Krishna's Lakshmi anywhere. Unnecessarily. No, this is Guru Krishna's. You cannot use like that. You can say, I am earning. No, you are belongs to Guru and Krishna. Your money belongs to Guru and Krishna. Once, what happened? Gurudev was there at that time. 25 paisa. In India, 100 paisa is 1 rupees. 25 paisa. Now it is rejected in India. And 125 paisa just put on from Gurudev's hand. And he's just going towards, how can you say, like some gadres, Almira. Going inside. And Gurudev was searching 25 paisa for more than half hour. 25 paisa, sir. Then servant came saying, Gurudev, why, what you are searching? I lose 25 paisa. Gopal's. This is Gopal's. He's going in this direction. You saw. Then bring broomstick and found out 25 paisa. Then Gurudev said, yes, 25 paisa. Now devotee is not caring, Lakshmi, immediately using. You have no Guru Darshan means no Krishna Darshan. I am belongs to Guru. This property belongs to Guru. Everything is Prabhupada's, Acharya's. If you have not this Darshan, you cannot see Krishna. Now your vision is coming, material vision. Material vision will come. So mananasilanam, Krishna is coming for them. Those are 24 hour thinking about Krishna. For them Krishna is coming to teach them what is bhakti. And for paramahansas, those devotees very expert to discriminate what is soul, what is body. And third one, amilatmanam. Amilatmanam. Those are free from all sort of desire. Heart is very cleansed. For them Krishna is coming. Amilatmanam. And Prabhupada always mentioning Amilatmanam means free from lust and greed. Greediness and lust. For them Krishna is coming. what to speak about us? Kuntidevi saying, Stri jate mama ka vartaha, Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur saying, where I am? Stri jati, I am belongs to women categories. Ka vartaha, what to speak about women? You are coming for paramhansas. You are coming for amilatmanas and mananasilanas, munin. Paramahansa. two birds are there. Their nature is different. Among the bird, who is Sudra? Who is Chandal? Crow. Pakhinams kaka chandalam. Among chandal, how can you say in English? Lowest. Dog eater. Phalen. You can say dog eater. Phalen. Among the bird, most phalen is crow. Among the animal, swanam. Pasunam swana chandalam. Among the animal, dog. Pasunam swana chandalam. Among the saintly persons, who is chandal? Who is very angry, always in angry mood. How can you say in krodhi? Always angry, fighting mood, that chandals. Muninam kopi chandalam. Among the central persons, those are very furious attitude, always fighting mood, the chandals. Or Chanakya Pandit is mentioning. So, best among the bird, best is swan. And worst is? We are crow. Guru is? But we are always forgetting this point. We are crow. What is crow's nature? Always shouting. You see, always shouting. Come, come, come. Always. Morning start? Shouting start. And always crow nature, always going to dirty, remnants, dirty things, always eating. We are always like that. We are always like that. Guru is always swan. We are always crow. Don't forget that thing. Crow always depend on swan. One story is there for small children. One king's son, he was keeping crows and always feeding remnants. And when crow became fat, they think we are now, how can you say, healthy? We are now great. From this story, we have to know we are crow, don't compete with swan. Our only shelter is swan. Otherwise we will fall down. From this story, when I read, I came to realize, oh, this story is applicable for us. So when crow became fat, crows, they are always, how can you say, fly in zigzag. Crows are always flying in like that, in zigzag way. So they are just flying nearby the ocean. They saw swans are there. When they saw swans, immediately say, we want to compete with you. This is the nature of crow. Those are crow-minded. Their mind is always want to compete with swan. Swan said, why you competed with me? Because our position is always we are staying in Mansarovar. In Himalaya, Mansarovar is there. We are staying there. Always we are drinking pure water. And we have capacity to fly. We have long distance we can fly. You cannot follow us. But crow saying, no. because only by eating remnant, he is now little fat. He want to compete with. This is our position. 20 or 30 years, we are eating only remnants. After 30 years, we are thinking, I am a senior devotee. I want to compete with Guru, Acharyas. And then Swan said repeatedly, please. Crow said, you know, I am very expert. I can flash with hospitality. But Swan said, no. We can fly in one speedy, stable, in stable journey. Our journey is stable journey. You cannot, for long distance we can fly. You cannot fly. But Crow said, no, I want to compete with you. They said, let come. Swan said, let come. Actually, Swan don't want to compete with Crow. A pure devotee don't want to compete with Crow. But sometimes to curse his pride, to rectify, he said, okay, please come. And then they start to fly. And in the beginning, Crow fly like a zigzag way like that. And just after 1-2 miles, Crow is now tired. Because Crow cannot fly so long. Swan is always flying in constant speed, stable speedy. Now Swan looks towards Crow. Crow is just going to fall down on the ocean. And his, how can you say, the wings now touch into water. And Swan saw, oh, what is going on? You want to compete with me? Then return. Swan then returned. And saying to Crow, hey, you are very expert. What is going on? He said, please, excuse me. Because Crow at that time wanted to take rest. And he was searching, where is tree? Within ocean, you can find tree? And this is our position. This is our, we are like Crow. Don't forget our position is higher than Crow. Then when he says going to, I can say, drown in the ocean, then Swan said, please, come. And just take rest over my lap, over my wing. I can carry you. So from this story, who is our shelter? Don't develop Crow mentality, not Crow mentality. Crow mentality. He is always showing his expertness and he wants to compete with the acharyas. This is Crow mentality. Krishna came personally for Paramahansas, Kunti Devi saying. For topmost devotees. And our position is like Crow. You see, from Bhagavatam, what Sukadeva Goswami is saying? Parinishto pinai gurnyam Uttama sloka lilayam gruhita cetana jarsi akhyana jatadittavanam. Parikita Maharaj was astonished. Sukadeva Goswami is transcendentalist. How can you say? His senses are purified. Why he scrutinizedly studied Srimad Bhagavatam? He was Brahmavadis. Paramahansas. But this is Krishna's lila's power, bhakti's power. Poor Sanakas, Sukadevs, all are transcendentalists. Their senses, our senses have material propensities. But those devotees have senses already purified, for them Krishna is coming. For them. Then where is Krishna's position? And pure devotee's position and where we are. This is our misfortune in life. We are not judging our own position. Own position. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, this is our position. Gopi bhartu das, gopi bhartu padakamalayo das, dasanu das. This is our position. Don't forget this one. even we are eligible to achieve Krishna prem, still our position is Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhur Dasir Anudas. Shri Krishna Seva Abhilas Kare Naruttama Das. This real ego always, how can you say, 100% mature. 100% mature. Therefore, they are pure devotees. More you become pure, more your, how can you say, this servitor mood, mood of servitor mood, sabhya bhav, sevak bhav, to serve spiritual master, to serve Krishna, a spiritual hankering will come. And you think yourself fallen, and sometimes, you can say, I think myself fallen, but I have no inspiration to do service. Sometimes devotees say, I'm so fallen, I can't serve Krishna. This is not Krishna's mercy. This is weakness. You have to discriminate yourself. What is weakness and what is Guru and Krishna's mercy? When Guru Krishna's mercy will come, when weakness comes, you will not get inspiration to serve Guru and Krishna. That means anarthas are there. But when mercy will come, two things will come. Inspiration comes from your heart to serve more and more, and same time you will think I am fallen. Because I am fallen and I have no, how can you say, I have no qualification, I am not achieving mercy, I have to serve more and more. Inspiration, you will not lose inspiration. You are losing inspiration means Guru Krishna's mercy is not there. To continue our inspiration, we have to always attached towards Guru and Krishna's service. This is the most important thing. And sometimes devotees saying, no, I have no qualification. Okay, if you have no qualification to serve Krishna, then you have qualification to serve Maya. To serving Maya is more difficult than to serving Krishna. To serving Maya is very difficult, 100% difficult than to serving Krishna. This is fact or not? Maintaining one family, you are brahmachari, you don't know. Those are married, you ask, maintaining one family, such a big burden. 24 hours you have to think about your family. Where is my son, where is my daughter, whether gas is there, whether electric bill is there, whether I pay electric bill or not. 24 hours a big burden, like a big mountain. Serving Maya is not easy. And serving Krishna is very easy. Very easy. But we have no propensity. Serving Guru and Krishna means protection is there. When we are serving Guru and Krishna, who protect us? Guru and Krishna protect us. Protection is there. Like someone working under a roof, then no sunlight. And someone working without roof, without umbrella in the green field, then direct scorching heat. Metal world is like that. Here protection is there. Hope is there. When we are serving Guru and Krishna, hope is there. Always hope. You will never lose faith. Like two words is there. In English it's called be sure. Be sure, don't fear. If you are a servant, if you are a real servant, don't fear. And be sure, Krishna will protect you. Gurudev will protect you. Be sure. But we have fearness. We are developed a fearness towards material world, towards body. This is not the nature of surrenderness. This is like a, how can we say, like a royal king. A king is coming in royal dynasty, and when he was climbing over a, how can we say, chariot or horse, when he was moving, you see drum, someone playing different music, many soldiers are there. So our path is like that. When you are serving Guru and Krishna, you are like a hero. One of his purport Prabhupada told, when there is service, there is no tiredness. No tiredness. You don't feel tired. If someone is saying, I am tired, means he is not serving. When you are serving in pure mood, spiritual energy will come. You will not feel tired. Always you feel, how can I say, always you feel like strengthy, you feel strengthy. You saw Prabhupada. From his lecture, his words still like bombastic words, 7-year world. Don't be all. Chant Hare Krishna, how you sing? Now no one can say like that. Because such a connection with Mahaprabhu, with Parampara, and mercy was flowing. And don't feel Prabhupada tired. We are young, we are traveling from here to there, then we feel tired. But 70-year-old traveling at that time, not so much facilities. Why don't feel tired? Spiritual energy. So Krishna, just coming for these three, how can we say, this Paramahansas, Munis, and Amalatmas. And Prabhupada write down many things about Amalatmas. Unless we free from lust and greedy, it is very difficult to advance in spiritual life. This is Prabhupada always saying, this is the real dirtiness in our heart. Lust and greed. And serving by spiritual master, praying sincerely, and by hearing and chanting, we can clean all these things. Only. Otherwise, there is no other way. And today I was reading Prabhupada's purport. From lecture, Prabhupada saying, I have one qualification only. My Gurudev at that time speaking such high philosophy, even I am not understanding, but I have only one qualification. I am just sitting and hearing. I am just sitting and hearing. But at that time, my Gurudev was speaking so high philosophy. But I have only one qualification. I'm just sitting and hearing my Gurudev's Krishna Katha. Actually, this hearing and serving spiritual master and chanting and develop a special attachment towards, how can you say, Guru Krishna Kaindrik Jivan. That means our center, our life center should be based on Guru and Krishna. All our activities, daily activities, our life activities should based on Guru and Krishna's. Kaindrik Jivan means center is Guru and Krishna. For His pleasure, always we have to work. Then it is possible. Krishnaya Vasudeva, again. After saying, first saying, Namasya Purusattvadyam. And why I am paying obeisances? He just, because I have no qualification, I am not a devotee, I am not a jnani, therefore I am repeatedly paying obeisances. And why he paying obeisances? In two words, he explained. Because you are in absolute platform, I have no capacity to realize you, therefore I am paying obeisances. Again paying obeisances. Krishnaya Vasudevaya Devaki Nandanaya cha Nanda Gopakumaraya Govindaya Namo Namaha. But Namo Namaha you have to add everywhere. Krishnaya Namo Namaha. Vasudevaya Namo Namaha. Govindaya Namo Namaha. Nanda Gopakumaraya Namo Namaha. Devaki Nandanaya Namo Namaha. You have to add. I want to pay obeisance to you. I want to pay obeisance. Actually, sincere devotees, when he pay obeisances, obeisances have such a power. By obeisances, you can melt heart of Guru and Krishna. You can melt. You see Bali Maharaj. Before going to Sutal, Bali Maharaj recite one verse. अहो प्रणामस्य कृत समुद्यमम. When Vamandev said, Bali, you just go to Sutal, next Manyuntar you will become Indra, and now you can get same facilities like Indra. I already construct another Indra Lok for you in Sutal. You just go and enjoy there. And I will be personal present there as a guard, security guard, 24 hours. 24 hours security guard is there, but different security guards doing their duties. But in Sutal Lok, Vamandev just working as security guard 24 hours, only one security guard. 24 hour duty. Why he is mobilized? Because only Atma Samarpan, he just give everything without hesitation for Krishna. Without hesitation. Dedication has such a power. We are dedicating something and in exchange we want something. But actually your dedication will never vanish. Whatever, he may be grasta, he may be sannyas, whatever he is dedicating something, his dedication towards Guru and Krishna, he may go to anywhere, his dedication, his service will follow. Service towards Guru and Krishna will never vanish. But we want immediate result. I am doing this thing, why this? But you are serving there, it will come to you. It will come to you. Only Guru Krishna knows. Therefore, don't disappoint. Your dedication will never vanish. Bali Maharaj is giving everything to Krishna, Vamandev. But when Vamandev said, I already arranged one another Indra Lok for you in Sutal, and sometimes next Manantra you will become Indra, and in this time also, I want to associate with you in Sutal. 24 hour I will work as a security guard. Then Bali Maharaj started to cry. You are so merciful. When I came to know that you are Supreme Personality of Godhead, from that time I never pay obeisance to you. Before I pay obeisance to you as a Brahman. When you came, at that time I pay obeisance, yes, I worship you as a Brahman. But when my Gurudev Shukracharya told him, you know, his Supreme Personality of Godhead, he will just take everything from you and giving to Indra. You don't give three steps. When my spiritual master recognized you and told that you are Supreme Personality of Godhead, but this was my duty at that time to pay obeisance to you. Before I pay obeisance to you as a Brahman. But I just develop a fearness because my Gurudev not liking you. How can in front of my Gurudev I can pay obeisance to you? I have desire to pay obeisance to you. But I have no chance. But you are so merciful, even I never pay obeisance to you. But you giving such a position to me. This is nature of, this is Krishna's nature. Only by one obeisances, if some devotee pays sincerely to Radha Madhav, to Panchatattva, to Nrsingadev, to Krishna, to Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu, you are only my savior. If you want, only you can save me. I am a blind person. Bhakti yoga, many, how can I say, supports are there. Many supports. Seva, Guru Seva, Tulsi Seva, Hulinam Seva, Dham Seva, Vaishnav Seva, Bhagavat Seva. But we are not, how can I say, seriously attached to anyone, and we don't know the glory. Even paying obeisances, you can conquer Krishna. You can conquer sadhu. Such power. How much importance we are giving towards devotional paraphernalia. That is, when we hear more, then we are giving more importance. You see, when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu paying obeisance to Ishwarpuri and sing something, you have power to give me Krishna prema. I am just giving this body. I am your servant. Such a humble mood, Mahaprabhu. unless we hear, very difficult to know all these tattvas. Unless our mind is convinced with all these tattvas, how can we develop seriousness? Now we want to develop our seriousness officially. This is a problem. Officially seriousness will come. Like officer is serious for how many hours? 8 hours or 10, from 10 to 4. He is not serious if master is not there, officer is not there, staff is not serious. If officer is there, he is officially very serious. Hey, officer is there, he is just working. If officer is not there, just sit in office, not working. This is called official seriousness. Now we are officially serious, not naturally serious, because we don't know tattvas. This is my duty. To pray like this, to serve spiritual master, according to my best capacity. I know I have no purification, many hindrances are there, but I will try. I will not give up this path. Anyhow. Our Gurudev used to say, where is another path? You can show me. If you give up bhakti yoga, is there any path which is very sublime? You can show me. Then if you are going in a sublime, well, how can you say, like very suitable, sublime, blissful way in path, but still some problem is coming. You say a problem is coming. If you give up, there is no other way. There is no other path. But let problem come, let danger come or happiness come. I have to serve Guru and Krishna, Guru and Gauranga in this life. By anyhow. If this way problem coming, I will come that way. If that way coming, I have to. You see, sometimes the thieves, if they have no chance to pickpocket, like to theft from somewhere, sometimes if they saw the police is not in proper consciousness. The theft from police. I know. It's a police staff, they're not serious. They make friendship with them police and from police pocket because their tenderness is there. They developed attachment to that. They're not getting some chance. They're not find some chance. So in another way, they're just theft from police. So if you develop attachment towards Guru and Krishna, no one can check you. Either in this way or in this. Because you already got some test. Some test is there in seva. Some test is there in Guru Krishna's attachment. I cannot give up it. I can't give up it. Anyhow. And if disturbance or some problem is coming, it is for some time. To make you glorify. To give you another test. But this is life. Without Guru Krishna's seva, no life. They're repeatedly saying, Krishnaya Namaha, Vasudevaya Namaha, Devaki Nandanaya Namaha, Nandagopa Kumaraya Namaha. And Vishwanath Thakur, whole purport Prabhupada mentioning in his purport. Vishwanath Thakur's commentaries, Prabhupada mentioning in his purport. Kunti, why praying? I am not qualified like Nanda, Yashoda. I am not qualified like Gopis. I am very insignificant, a fallen servant. Humble servant. Please, therefore I am paying obeisance to you. Please use our mercy. Okay, tomorrow we will hear more. A big topic. And I am not discussing so much about, because to speak in English in commentaries, very difficult. And long commentaries. And very valuable commentaries. Vishwanath Chakur Thakur's commentaries. Hare Krishna. Okay. If you have some question, now time is 12. Okay. No more question. Okay. Hare Krishna, Jai Prabhupada Ji Maharaj Ki Jai, Srila Gurudev Ki Jai, Ananda Koti Vaishnava Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai, Sri Sri Radha Madhava Pachita Nrisimhadev Bhagavan Ki Jai, Sambit Bhakta Vrinda Ki Jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari.